Hey guys, Scott Connell here from Prima Consulting. Today I'm going to give you a brief overview of some of the aspects of Visual Planner, an amazing product by PowerOn that was designed to complement the world-leading Power BI service. As you can see, there are a few small changes to some of the elements on the screen from what you'd be used to. With Visual Planner, you can now enter data directly into Power BI and write back to your datasets in a matter of seconds. Everything else is entirely Power BI, so training times are super quick and let you retain the full customization that Power BI provides. Let's use sales budgeting as an example. I'm going to look at one of my salesmen, Ben Noble, and one of his key clients, Tesco. As you can see, we have a range of products listed in the PowerOn matrix table. Ben has recently let me know that cola sales at Tesco are going to be far higher than expected due to their growing customer base. At a high level, I can edit the total budgeted figure for this element and the change will be proportionally reflected across the relevant fields. Let's say 8 million. I enter the figure, click save. And as you can see, all fields have been refreshed to reflect the updated total. These figures are live and have been written back to your on-prem or cloud dataset, and your entire Power BI report has been updated. To easily share this knowledge with other team members and executives, I can now enter a comment against this field. I click the cell, enter the reason for the change, click save, and now you can see we have a comment showing, just like how Excel displays comments. The best part, these comments are saved at the intersection of data within the data model itself. So if I clear my filter, you see the comment I made disappears. And now we're looking at an entirely new set of comments made at the overall corporate view. When I click back to Ben Noble, the comment I just made reappears because it is saved at the intersection of data within our data model. Really awesome functionality that lets users come in and leave comments that are highly visible to other business users. Another aspect is using smart formulas. Let's say I've brought in actuals from the past 12 months and I'm looking to increase Q1 cola sales by 10%. I select the field, enter the smart formula, click save, and all fields in Q1 have been increased proportionally by the desired percentage. A third option is to use the goal seek function. This is super useful if you're looking to proportionally change a section of your budget without affecting all categories. Using the same example, I want to decrease all sales in Q1 except for tonic. I click the total for each section and select goal seek, then enter decrease 20% on the Q1 total, click save, and easy as that, all three sections have now been decreased by 20%, while tonic stays the same. Lastly, let's look at using the drag and drop visual to update our figures. What we've got here is a 100% line graph that allows us to change data on a purely visual level. Ben's come to me and said that total sales will stay the same, but January to March is going to be much higher than thought. So using Visual Planner, I can go in and adjust those months based on Ben's input. I click and drag each month, click save, and once again, the updated figures have written back to our underlying data and refreshed the entire Power BI report. As you can imagine, there are a huge number of use cases for how Visual Planner can transform the use of Power BI within your organization. I hope you guys enjoyed this brief overview of some of the aspects of Visual Planner by PowerOn. Please reach out to myself and the team at Prima Consulting if you'd like to learn more or see a full product demonstration.